This is Mr. Oman, and I'm going to show you how to get started with some basics in Revit architecture. In order to get to this screen right here, I need you to go down to the Start menu, click on that. You can either type in Revit, R-E-V-I-T. Usually that will come up right there, and you can select that option. If you can't find that, another way to do it would be to go under All Programs. It's located in, under Autodesk. Scroll down to Revit Architecture 2013, and Revit Architecture 2013 is your selection, not the viewer. So you would double click that, click, and this screen would pop up right here. This is the welcome screen. Helps you decide where to go. These options right here, these are files that I've opened recently. Okay, you probably don't have this on your screen. So I'm gonna suggest you go under the Projects menu and click on New. Make a new project. All right, hit OK for architectural template project. OK, right there, and our project should open up for us. Okay, now this opening scene here, this scene is basically like you having a piece of paper on your table and you're about ready to draw on that paper with a pencil or a pen. Okay, and your cursor is basically your pencil or pen. Okay, so we're looking down on paper. These markers right here, these are just little camera views called elevation markers. They're going to look sideways at your drawing, kind of a side view of your object. I'm going to take you through and show you some items up here on what's called a ribbon. This ribbon is a set of buttons or commands that you'll be using in your project. And the most commonly used buttons are going to be over here on your left end. So you'll spend a lot of time in this area. If you hear me talk about clicking on a tab, these are tabs up here, starting with architecture, structure, insert, all the way down to modify. We'll use some of those as well. So these are tabs up here, and these are buttons on the ribbon down here. All right, let's start off. Let's get you going on a few commands here. We're in the architecture tab. We're going to left click on the wall command. I'll come out onto my drawing space. You'll notice down here on the bottom left hand side, it says click to enter wall start point. Okay, so down there, they're trying to tell you what to do. So follow along with that. I'm going to start out here in the middle of my camera views. I'm going to left click and notice I'm drawing a bird's eye view of a wall. And you see the farther I pull it out, the longer the wall is. I'm going to type in 20 feet on my keyboard. So it draws exactly 20 feet. Right there, I'm going to turn. I'm going to continue down. Let's go 8 feet. These are just example sizes I'm giving you. You could type again, or you could pull out until you see these construction dash lines that help you to line things up. I'm just gonna click there, and I'm gonna click up here to finish this off. All right, so we have a basic set of walls. Okay, to close that command, I'm gonna click on modify, or you can hit the escape key twice. Either of those will work. Okay, right now I'm zooming in and out with my wheel on my mouse, just rolling in and out like so. So you can get used to that. It will zoom in and out wherever you put your cursor. It'll aim at that location. So get used to placing that around. Try that out. Roll in and out. If you want to pan or drag your drawing around, I'm clicking down like a button on the wheel right now. You'll see that move arrow pop up. You can drag and just move it around as you want to. Again, those are mouse button clicks there. Or you can zoom right there. I'm going to show you a couple of different views here. If you want to hit the restore button right over here. Okay, it puts your window in kind of a smaller view like that. Again, this is still a two-dimensional floor plan view. Okay, that I'm in at the time. If you go up to the view tab, click on that. And if you click on 3D view, the little house right there, you'll see another window pop up showing you a 3D view of this drawing that you did previously. Okay, now they're kind of overlapping each other and a little bit awkward. I'm gonna suggest you stay in the view tab and go over to the tile button right there. It looks like two little windows near the right side of your screen. Click on that and it will tile those side by side and use your space well right there. So that's meant to make things a lot easier to view. Right there. Okay, moving on here, you'll find that our walls are pretty tall that we just made. OK, Okay, let's shorten these up. If I could have you click on, just pick any wall right now. Just click on it, click on an edge so it turns blue. All right, which means it's selected. You can grab onto these blue arrow grips if you want to, pull those up and down. Okay, but that's not always the most accurate. You know, okay, I've been dragging that around, creating different heights out of it. It's about 20 feet, it says over here right now. A typical wall is about 8, maybe 9 or 10 feet in a house. I'm gonna go with 8 feet. So right over here where it says unconnected height, I'm going to change that property right here to say 8 feet. And I'll type that on my keyboard to make that happen. I'll hit apply, and there it is. It sizes it right up for me, right down to 8 feet. Okay, if you'd like to do all of them at the same time, quick and easy way to do this, just hit the front view on the view cube up there, or you can drag it like this. I'm going to go to the top right part of that window, and drag from right to left, call it crossing window. That crossing window will select anything on the inside of it. If I went from left to right the other direction, if I'm not entirely around it, notice it does not select it for me, but it's different when I go from right to left. I only have to be just partly over it, and it'll grab those walls that are kind of tall. Okay, and I left my short one alone there. And I'm gonna change those all to be 8 feet and correct those all at the same time in one try. If you wanna do those individually, you could, but a quicker way is to do them all at once right there. So we have a 3D view and a 2D view, all of the same thing of this example home. All right, so far we've learned about some tabs, a couple of buttons. I'm gonna go back to the architecture tab where we once were. We've done wall. Let's add a door to this project and see what happens here. Let's left click on the door command. You'll notice that this door option has popped up over in our properties window. If you head out to your 3D view and you click in there, you'll see it start to show up. Okay, you do have to stick it to the side of a wall if you're in the 3D space. If you wanted to work over in the 2D space, two-dimensional space, you can go right on the wall. Notice when I'm not even close to the wall, it kind of blocks it out and won't let me do it. I have to go right up to the wall. This is because doors are hosted by walls in this Revit program. It knows not to put a door out in the middle of nowhere out here. You've got to be right on a wall. So I'm just going to pick a spot for now. I'm not going to worry too much about it. Well, let's put a couple of doors in like that. Okay, so there's your door command. I'm gonna hit modify to end that command. All right, let's say I don't have the door that I like out here. This is the wrong size or the wrong style. Okay, you can click right on it. Okay, and just like with the wall command, we came over here to the properties browser, and you can look at the different properties of that object that you have selected. So right now it's thinking only about that door that I picked. So for example here, if I go and pull down, hit that pull down arrow, and you'll see some different sizes that show up right there. So maybe I wanted a 36 by 84. Actually, that's what I have, is 36 by 84. What if I wanted 30 by 80, for example? Click on that, you'll see the door just got a little bit narrower. 30 by 80, right there. Maybe that's not the right style. Okay, if you want to change to a different style, you're gonna need to go to the insert tab up here. Click on that. We're gonna load a new family of doors. So click on load family, and this family folder will come up. I'm gonna open up the doors family folder, and you'll see a lot of different choices. If you just single click on these, I'm just doing just one click right now, you'll see some different previews showing up on the right hand part of your screen, different styles. Let's say this is a closet door, a four panel bifold closet door. Okay, click that, hit open. All right, it appears like nothing is going to happen. Okay, that bifold door did not appear right here. It did load it up, just hasn't put it into place yet. So in order to do that, I have to go back to the door command. Okay, bring that in. You'll see that show up there. Okay, so there, I just put in a new bifold door. Okay, let's say I want to change this existing door that I already put in. Okay, maybe I put the wrong style in. If I click on that. Okay, now that I've loaded that up using the load family command, you'll see it's a part of my list where I wasn't there before. Okay, so In this case, I could click on that style and there it makes the change. So even if you put the wrong one out there in your project, you can still easily go back and edit that. All right, so far we've learned how to do walls and doors and make a few changes to those items using the properties browser. Okay, next up I'd like to show you how to put in some windows and even put in a floor as well. Okay, so I'm gonna start off by, let's delete this door. I selected it. I'm using the delete key on my keyboard. Okay, to delete that and make some space for a window. Up here on the architecture tab, you'll notice that there's a window command right here. Just do a left click on that. You'll see my window property has shown up over here with its properties as well, right below it. I'm gonna come right out into my screen. You'll see once I get out into my 2D space that I have selected, it will show up once I get onto a wall. Just like our doors, you can't put them out in space. They're hosted by the wall. So I'm gonna click there. Okay, and you'll see it also show up over in 3D view. So I'm kind of watching 3D space while I'm actually working in 2D. That's why I like to have both windows open as well. Let's see, let's put another one in over here as well. You'll see a couple show up there. Hit modify to end that command. And there we are. We've got a couple sets of windows. Once again, if you want to change those, you have the opportunity to go over here, pick different sizes. You'll see those changes are made. Let's say you pick a window here that's too big for the wall, or at least the position is too big. You can edit that as well. You select it. Okay, the sill height is the bottom height of the window. There's the sill down there. Okay, and you'll see some options here. Here's head height. I know that that wall is 8 feet tall, and if that's 9 feet, we're 1 foot too high. So let's change this to be, let's do 6 feet, 8 inches. 6 feet, 8 inches right there. And either apply or enter on the keyboard. You'll see it update over here. Let's rotate and look in there. All right, so that seems to work right there. All right, there's a window. And again, if you want to change the style of the window, you don't like that single pane window that I have in there. Again, go to insert, load family. Windows are all the way down at the bottom. Double click. And if you do single clicks, you'll see different styles. Okay, maybe I want a double hung window that slides vertically up and down. Double click that. Okay, it loads it up into my properties browser. Let's change this window right here. I select, go into properties, and there's my double hung selection. I've got sizes I can pick from. I'm just gonna pick 24 by 48. There it is. Let's look at it in 3D so we can see what happens. There is a double hung window compared to my single pane window right there. All right, so that's a little bit about windows and changing its properties. In this next segment, I'm going to show you how to put a floor into your model here. That's this blue portion that I've already done. Okay, I'm going to delete that now and show you what it takes to make that. Okay, so I'm hitting the delete key. All right, so you're going to want to go to the architecture tab, find your floor command, which is right there. If you hover over, it'll give you a little description. Some of these commands will even have videos right in this area for you to watch. This one does not though. So I left click on the floor command and you'll notice that it automatically shifts you over to the modify tab. Okay, that you didn't even have to do that yourself. It just did that for you. Okay, a lot of commands. These commands only apply to this floor command that you have turned on. Okay, nothing else right now. Okay, within that ribbon of commands, you've got a bunch over here. I'm gonna use the rectangle option because you'll notice that our screen here has gone kind of gray, which seems like a problem, but really that means Revit has gone into a sketch mode and they want us to do some sketching. So I'm going to do a rectangle and I'm going to draw that floor in place. So you could do it in 2D space, you could do it in 3D, it's your choice. I'm going to zoom in and click on this outside corner in the 3D view. You'll see my rectangle forming. I want that rectangle to fit right underneath my model, because our floor fits exactly underneath that size. And I click over here as well. There's my rectangle. All right, and that's exactly what I need to draw. I'm satisfied with that. So I'm going to click this green check mark, which is called finish the edit or sketch mode. So I click there, and sure enough, it makes the floor in that space right there. If you'd like to change its properties, just like before, click over here in the properties browser. Let's make this one a 12-inch joist with carpet on the inside. So I click that, changes it. You'll see down in here, there's some carpet in there. Later we'll get into rendering and so that looks more realistic. But for now, just know that we've got a floor with some carpet on it. In this next segment, I'd like to show you how to add a second story or second level onto your house. So far we have a first floor or level one floor plan, and you'll see that that is what we by default have been sketching in right over here under your project browser. What I'd like to do next then is to have you double click on level two. Okay, and you'll see this new window pop up. Should look a lot like your level one floor plan. But now we're going to be basically upstairs, and they've kind of grayed out our first floor so we can see where it is, so we can sketch right over it and things end up the right size. Okay, so I'm in level two. Just like before, we'll hit the wall command. I'm going to zoom in right here into the center of the wall. Click endpoint. Basically, I'm going to kind of trace the center of the wall all the way around. About like that, and close it off right there. Okay, if you jump back to the 3D view back here, you'll see the work we've done. Okay, it might look a little bit odd at this point, but we can edit this. All right, you notice our walls are a little bit tall. Let's say I didn't like that. If you get tired of changing walls, what if we just want to get them right the first try? Okay, I'm going to delete that. I'm going to show you how to draw that better on the first try. So again, back to our level two floor plan. Let's click wall. Before we start clicking around here, let's change this dimension right here. It says 20 feet. It wants to make a 20-foot tall wall right away. I'm going to change that to be 8 feet because that's what I know I want them to all be in the end. Now let's go ahead and sketch in here these walls. And these are only 8 feet tall and not 20 like before. Okay, at this point it's hard to tell. But again, back over to 3D, now those seem a little bit more proportional to each other. So I just drew in the second story up above there. Okay. All right. And we'll add in a floor as well. Back to sketch mode, rectangular. Click and click. So I'm drawing a rectangle showing the floor. Hit finish. 3D mode, you'll see right there, we've got our floor in place. I'm gonna grab the second floor and its height offset. Let's have it come in at -1 foot. I wanna drop it down. It thinks it wants to put it in up at 10 feet here. Okay, but let's drop it down. There it is. Now it's actually sitting on the first floor walls. And let's also grab the second floor base offset. Let's have that come in at 1 foot down as well. Okay, and now the second floor is truly sitting on top of the first. Okay, and you can go ahead and you can add in doors and windows. I would do that back here in the second floor plan right here. Back to doors and windows. Putting in stairs is our next item. All right, looking at our three views here, I've got a level two, a level one, and a 3D view in place. If we're gonna get from level one up to level two, we're gonna need stairs. And stairs are under your architecture tab, right over here in the center, right there, and there's the stair command. You'll notice a couple options when you pull down, stair by component, stair by sketch. Either one is good. I'm gonna show this one using stair by sketch, meaning we're gonna draw it out first, and then we're going to let the program build it for us. So we'll click on that right there. I'm going to head into my first floor plan, level one, right over here, and we'll do some sketching to make this happen. So I'm going to hit my sketch command right there. You can see it's giving me a preview already of this thing right there. All I simply need to do is click a couple of times. There's the sketch. If I like it, I can hit the check mark right here and hit OK. and it will calculate and it will make that for me. Okay, so let's go check it out over in 3D World over here. We'll zoom in and let's see what we have. Okay, there it is poking through from the first floor all the way up to the second floor. You'll notice that our second floor flooring is in the way right here. Basically, we need a hole in the wall, hole in the floor, excuse me, to allow a person to walk up the steps to get it to the second floor. So let's back out. We need to do some editing to our floor. So I'm going to select. There's my second floor. It's selected now. It turns blue right there. And you'll notice that it jumps over to the Modify tab. Here's Edit Boundary. If I click on Edit Boundary, it goes back into sketch mode, and I'm going to edit that floor, and I'm basically going to cut a hole into the floor to allow the stairs through. I'll use my rectangle command again to make that happen. I'm going to go to my first floor plan, and let's click right about here, all the way down to there. Hit the check mark, and you'll notice over here in 3D space that we now have a hole cut into our flooring right there to allow the stairs to fit through. Okay, so that works out pretty well for us. If you don't like the size of that opening, we can certainly go back into Edit Boundary. You can click on one of those pink lines and grab it and pull it over. Maybe you want a little bit more flooring up in your second floor. Something like that. Right there, hit the check mark to accept it. And there we are. That might seem a little bit more realistic to us. I notice we have a closet door in the way down there. That doesn't quite work out, so I'm gonna delete that. We don't really need that too much. Hit the delete key, should make more sense. Looks like our window from the first floor is fitting just underneath our stairs. So that works out pretty good. Let's draw the roof next for this house. I have an example done already here, shown in blue. It's not a real interesting roof. I guess it's not a real interesting house either, for that matter. But here's what's going to happen when we get done. I'm going to delete this first, though. I'm going to go back and show you how to draw that. Okay, so I'm sitting here in 3D view. I simply just maximized my 3D view of the house. There it is. I'm going to go up to my Architecture tab, over to Roof, which is right there. Click on that. Would you like to put it on your level 2? Yes, I want that to sit on level 2. If you say no, it'll put it way down on the first floor. Even so, here in the second floor, it kind of wants to set the roof right on the floor, which doesn't make sense. You actually want your roof to set up on the wall. So what I need you to do when you draw your roof is to experiment with the base offset. I've had a chance to do this already. I'm gonna have mine sitting 7 feet up off the floor. Yours probably says 0 right now, so try changing that to about 7. If that's wrong, try 8. Okay, I will do some drawing just like I drew the floor earlier. You could either use your line command or rectangle type command. All right, I'll use the line command. If you come in here, you can click. Actually, why don't I go to my second floor to do this? I'm gonna click right on those endpoints. And those pink squares show up, that's your end snaps right there. It'll snap right to the end of the house. So I'm just kind of tracing what's already here for that. And I'm gonna hit the check mark to have it draw it, to say okay. All right, would you like to attach the highlighted walls to the roof? Yes, you do want those two to attach to each other. Okay, and here in 3D, there it is. Okay, it's very possible yours, if you haven't changed the base offset from 0, your roof probably looks like this. There's the stairs poking out of it. Again, this is where you'd want to select it and change that to be about 7 feet right there. Experiment with that number. Okay, now let's make our roof a little bit more interesting looking though. Okay, it doesn't overhang the side of the house at all. It just comes right to the edge. All right, and if you don't like this style of roof, we can change that easily as well. All right, so I've got that selected. I'm going to go up here to Edit Footprint. So if you want to make changes, you go to that button. There's that original sketch. Let's say I didn't want the slope of the roof to slant towards this end of this house. I select that, And right up here, once I've got it selected, you'll see it says define slope. If I uncheck that box, okay, I will no longer have roof slope on this side of the house. Let's do it again down on this other end. Again, uncheck that box right there. Hit the check mark. Let's see what happened. Look at that. We just changed from a hip roof to a gable end right there. Okay, so you can experiment with that little feature. Let's edit the footprint some more and let's get some overhang hanging over the sides of our walls. So if I click here on this one, I'm gonna drag this out. Let's say I want 1 foot overhangs. If I just double click and I can type in 1 foot, enter, and let's see what happens there. Hit the check mark and notice that my roof is already overhanging on this end. I have to repeat the same set of directions to the other sides, but so far there it is. I'll let you do the other three sides. Let's make our model look a little more interesting. Something like this. We got a little bit of color, a little bit of shade going here, and we have some ground on the outside, also known as the topo surface or the site. Okay, so here's where we're going. I'll delete these for now. And you probably still have your drawing in what's called wireframe or possibly hidden line setting right there. So let's start with that. How do you get your project to look kind of nice? Go down here to the visual style editor down here at the bottom of your screen. Click on that. This menu pops up. You've been operating in hidden line so far. I'd recommend using shaded. Shaded looks nice. You can see things pretty well. And it also doesn't bog down your computer and make your computer slow. If you choose to go to realistic or ray trace and so on, these will look nice, but you can see it took my program a moment to kind of chug along and get that to work. So you just know that you will be experiencing slower processing times if you use those. So I'm in shaded. Let's make our site next. If you go up to the massing and site tab in the top center of your screen, let's click on topo surface. Right there. I'll head over to my site plan. So over here in your project browser, double click on site. You'll get a window here that says site plan. And there's mine right there. I'm going to double click that one and make that large. I'm in sketch mode, so it is grayed out. Right now it wants me to place some points to make a surface. So I'm just going to draw kind of a rectangle around it. And it will form a nice surface once I hit the check. And I'll see that over in 3D space right there. Okay, in the real world, yes, they would have an exact site measured out, but for now, this is just a quick way to get one in. If you wanna edit it and make your project kind of contoured or have some slope to it, you can click on it, go to edit surface up here. Under the tools menu, you'll see this pulls down. You can put place point. We're just gonna put what's called topo points or surveying points. Let's place some of those in here. Try not to go too crazy with this part. Just put a few in place so you have some right there in your site plan. Hit check. Okay, if you go back to the 3D space, maximize that. I'm gonna click on the front view of my view cube right there. So I'm looking exactly sideways at it. If I select my surface here, we can edit the surface by grabbing on. I'm selecting a few of these points and I'm going to just lightly drag these things down and create kind of the illusion that we have some slope in our yard right there. Okay, if you want to grab the whole project, hit escape. I'm sorry, you have to hit your check mark first. And you can just drag it down once that move command shows up. And if you're still not satisfied, go back to edit surface, select a few points, and again you can drag that. I'm keeping my house in mind here as I do this. You can see my house appears to be floating, so that doesn't work. I need to kind of fix that up just a touch right there. Okay. Hit the check mark, look at it in 3D. There you are, you have a site in place. We're going to create some 3D camera views and some renderings to kind of make our project look interesting now. So far we've had kind of a boring look to it. Here's where the artistic side kind of comes out in this program. We'll head up to the 3D button, 3D view button under the view tab. Here it is. If you hit the pull down arrow from 3D view, you'll find camera right there. I'm going to click on the camera option. And right now it's set to take a shot from level 2. Let's go down to level 1. Let's change that. So if yours says level 2, please change that to level 1. We're going to head into the level 1 floor plan. And let's put a camera down here at the bottom of the stairs. And let's aim it towards the stairs, and it automatically creates a 3D view of what this thing looks like. Okay, if you didn't quite aim it the way you wanted to, you can always change what you get in your view here by dragging these blue grips. I'm going to adjust that until I like it right here. So we have a pretty close-up view of those stairs. Okay, and you can kind of create some of these views to make your house look very interesting and interesting to the viewer. I think that's pretty good right there. Okay, over on the left-hand side here, you probably didn't notice it when this happened, but under the 3D views section of the project browser, all of a sudden this term 3D view 1 just showed up. That's the name for this picture. Okay, if you don't like this picture, you can hit close and it will erase that from your list. If you like it, I would suggest renaming it. Let's right-click on it and hit Rename. Let's do 3D Stair View is what I'm going to name mine. Okay, if you had a view of your, let's say, the master bedroom, a 3D view, you might want to name it that, or whatever room you're representing in your view. Okay, so this is another one of our little windows that we've created here over in our project browser. Okay, so that's the camera. Let's head into our 3D space here. Let's take a 3D rendering. A rendering is an artistic view of your object. So again, under View tab, there's Render right there. Click on that, please. You've got some settings you can work with here. I'll just show you a few of them. First of all, if you leave it at draft and you just hit the render button, okay, you'll see what happens. It takes a moment, it'll render it. It'll take this almost like a camera shot. It won't look the greatest, but it's a real quick and fast way to take a picture of your project. Okay, you'll see some properties are showing up, some of the wood on the door, the wood on the trim around the window is showing up. We haven't put any material properties on our project yet, so it doesn't look real great, but the ground outside does. If you don't like that one, you could go up to medium or high. These will take us a little bit longer, okay, but the quality is going to look quite a bit better. So once you've had a chance to play with your material settings, you'll probably want to try it out at a higher level. Okay, it's looking a lot more fine, not such a coarse result. Okay, you can see where that's going. I'm going to hit cancel. I know I'm going to make some more changes to this. Yes, I want to stop that operation. Okay, let's go back and let's change our materials of our project. So let's take one of these walls, for example. So this first wall right in front of me on the second floor, you could grab anyone for this example, but right now it's just a generic 8-inch wall, not real interesting. If you go ahead and look through the list here, you can go all the way down to making a storefront, a glass window storefront. You can put brick exterior on it, whatever you want. Let's try brick right here. Let's just try a few settings out here. If I can get a hold of this wall, there it is. Let's try a storefront. Just see what happens there. We'll give you some variety. Okay, there it is. Back to view. And let's hit render. Yeah, let's use the medium setting for now. Let's see if those two walls turn out a little better than they did the first time. Okay, and that gives you kind of an interesting look there. I'm gonna let this finish. Okay, let's say that's totally done. That's the way you want it right there. It looks nice. you would want to go down to the bottom where it says save to project. Okay, and let's just call this 3D rendering. Okay, you can name it something else if you want. Okay, let's close our rendering. And now that we've saved a rendering, you'll notice that down here in the list, renderings all of a sudden shows up. This was not here before we did that rendering. There it is, there's the one I typed in. If I double click that, there's that picture we just rendered. Okay, so there's a couple of pretty interesting views. All right, so we're getting a lot of stuff out here. All right, one more thing I want to show you is how to create a 3D section view. Okay, so I'm going to head back to my 3D window right here. If I go over into my properties browser, I can scroll down till I find the section box. There it is over here. So again, I scroll down to find that section box. If you check it, you'll notice this box that kind of goes around your object. If you select that, you can grab these blue grips and pull them in, and you can cut right into your house and create a 3D cross section of your house, which is kind of fun right there. You kind of drag that around until you like it. You can do these in all three dimensions. I'll give you a little bit of each right there. Okay, so you can adjust that. Typically, you want to show your stairs when you do a section view. Like that. All right, now to finish this off, we need to create sheets. Okay, a sheet for printing this out. If you scroll down in your project browser down here, you'll find that there's a sheet section. There's not much happening in there yet until you right click on it, go to new sheet. And right now we're trying to print on 30 by 42 size paper. That's really large paper. Let's load it up and let's go down to Titleblocks. Titleblocks are little borders that you'll put around your drawing. For this example, we'll do A size paper, which is your 8.5 by 11, typical printer paper. You can do B size if you have bigger printer paper and so on. We'll just do the A size. Double click that, it loads it up. Come down and hit OK. There it is, we just created another sheet. Another window, that is. Okay, if you would like to get your picture to land inside this title block, you go back over to your project browser, find whatever it is you want to show. So how about that 3D stair view? I can drag that picture and I can put it right in into this object, into this sheet right there. Okay, so that's kind of neat. If you'd like to put another one in, there's my 3D rendering. I can go grab that and drag that over here. Okay, I probably don't have room yet for it. See, those kind of crowd each other out. If you'd like to adjust the size, you can adjust it here, but if you head back to the original pictures, here's my 3D rendering. I can size it down here and then head back to my sheet. You'll see it get sized down there. My stair view, that thing's pretty large. So I'm going to adjust its size here. Like that. And back in my sheet. You'll see, there they are, they're sized down. I'm gonna move that so it fits. And I see the titles have moved with it there. You can drag and adjust those till they fit just fine for you. And so on. All right, that's how you render, take camera views, and create sheets. And, oh, and one more thing. You can adjust the names right down here in the title block. And for me, I would type Mr. Oman. That, and you can furthermore go in and change any more information you want right there.